Hello student, welcome to the EPG Pathshala. Myself Dr. Baljinder Singhil, Assistant Professor, Department of Biotechnology, Punjab University, Chandigarh. And I will discuss with you the module that is the possible risk that is posed by this nanoparticle itself under the paper that is Nanobiotechnology. So let us start with the module by introduction. Now the nanoparticle, they exist in the environment both as a natural, from the natural resources and also from the anthropogenic sources. And nanoparticle in the environment, they exist as a, that is a, in the air as a ultra fine particle, and in the aqueous and in the soil they exist as a colloidal sole. Now nanoparticle that exist in the air as a ultra fine particles, so there is always a possibility for their inhalation through normal breathing, and it can cause a health risk also. So this is one of the major risks of this nanoparticle that they pose. Now in the, because of their nano size, they exist as a ultra fine particle, like the, because they also in the air, the exact mechanism how they, the fate of this nanoparticle in the air, it is a still a topic of research, and researchers, they have not clearly understood the fate of this nanoparticle in the air also. And in the air, there is also a possibility of this ultra fine particle to clump together to form the large particle that then settle down. Now because it exists as a ultra fine particle, there is a possibility for the inhalation, so it will directly target the lungs and cause the lung toxicity and can affect the lung also. Now regarding their fate in the water, that is in the next slide. So regarding their fate in the water, their fate in the water will depend upon the solubility factor, their interaction with the water, it will depend upon the interaction with the water, how they interact with the water molecule or the water contaminant or other substance or the molecule. So these are the two parameter or the factor which will affect the fate of this nanoparticle in the water also. Also because there is no any clear mechanism understood after the end use of this nanoparticle, how, what are the fate of their nanoparticle in the water, it is also a topic of research. So they can affect the, because human, they depend upon three things: food, water and air. And they also cause the direct effect on the health of the human. Because of their nano size, they can also enter into the bloodstream, can affect almost all organ system of the body also. These nanoparticles, through entry through the water, they can affect all organ system of the body also. Also this nanoparticle, because of their nano size and high surface to volume ratio, they can interact with the molecule and they settle down in the soil also. Now in the water also and also in the soil, the various, whether they undergo abiotic or the biotic degradation, it is still not clear. Also in the air also, whether they undergo the photo, that is the in the presence of light, they break down into breakdown of this nanoparticle, whether occurred or not, it is also a question mark also. So in this chapter, regarding the learning outcome of this chapter or this module, or the objective of this this module, we will discuss about the, that is the various risk of this, that is nanoparticle that posed various risk. And among this, that is a one, that is we will discuss also about the fate and persistence of these nanoparticles in the environment. then their effect, including toxicology, and also we will discuss the assess the exposure condition of this nanoparticle also. So we will, in this chapter, we will discuss the toxicology mainly and their risk that is posed by this nanoparticle in the environment. Now the assessment of this nanoparticle exposure condition. Where are the possible chances where they posed a risk? Where are the chances? Because this nanoparticle, they are mainly prepared in the laboratory. So there is worker or the researchers which are handling this nanoparticle or which perform the synthesis of this nanoparticle, there is a possible risk or the chance for their, that is exposure condition, for their exposure. Then the after preparation of the synthesis, there is a characterization of this nanoparticle. Again, there is a possible risk. Then the transportation, because this nanoparticle, they are synthesized or produced at a large scale where the transportation is also involved. So overall, there is a chance of exposure that is for the researcher, that is during the handling and during the processing of this nanoparticle, because this nanoparticle, they are synthesized or prepared according to the demand and prepared by the various researcher, and the researcher which are handling or processing, they have the risk for the exposure with this nanoparticle. Therefore, careful handling is needed and careful instruction should be followed during the preparation, during the transportation of these nanoparticles. Regarding the possible risks of this nanoparticle that is created by this nanoparticle, so the environmental nanoparticle, they exist in the environment in the two form. One is the natural nanoparticles, second one is the engineered nanoparticle. Among the natural nanoparticle, the main is the atmospheric, terrestrial, aquatic, engineered, that is unintentional and intentional nanoparticles. Among the atmospheric, the example is inorganic, and similarly among the terrestrial and the aquatic, the example is inorganic as well as organic. Organic nanoparticle, they are mainly considered as a macromolecule, biocolloids and cellular debris. Among the inorganic, that is a silicate, oxides like metal oxide and hydroxides. And further, that is, we have already discussed the various nanoparticle, they are unintentional, they are also included in the inorganic, because the method involved is a inorganic method are involved for their synthesis. Now the engineered nanoparticle, one is intentional, that we have already prepared carbonaceous nanoparticle, metal oxides, semiconductor materials like titanium dioxide, zero valent metals or zero valent iron, that is mainly involved in the bioremediation of pollutants. Then the nanopolymers, they are the engineered nanoparticle. Unintentional are that are produced by the corrosion product and the waste product that are produced. So environmental nanoparticle, this is the basics slide which show the distribution of this environmental nanoparticles, because they itself pose a problem in the environment. Now the among the possible risk, the main, that is the major risk in the nanomaterial use or the use of nanomaterial for various purpose, including the their various application in an environmental, medicinal and agriculture field, the main is the nanotoxicology. Now the nanotoxicology of this nanoparticle, they are due to their mainly, that is because we have already discussed this nanoparticle, they are increasing a part of everyday consumer product, manufacturing process, and medical products. So there are, because there are several, also the several different mechanisms are involved to test the toxicity of this nanoparticle in the body. That we will discuss after this slide. Now, how they are more toxic? The first one is, that is surface area. These nanoparticles, they have small size, that is vary from 1 to 100 nanometer. That is why they show high surface to volume ratio. It increases the reactivity toward the, whether it is the contaminant or other organism or other substances. So the higher toxicity, that is due to the, compared to the other of same mass concentration of large particle of this nanoparticle, it is due to their higher surface area or due to their small size or the shape. Second one is the morphology. Among the morphology, the main is the particle shape. Now the shape may be, for example, spherical homogeneous shape of this iron oxide or the gold particle, and it also create the toxicity, because shape, it will determine the toxicity mechanism of the nanoparticle. For example, iron oxide or the gold having spherical homogeneous shape, they involved in the internalization and membrane disruption, and which lead to the membrane disruption if the shape is, that is a different as compared to the other nanoparticle. It actually disrupt the, that is the function of cell also. So the morphology, similarly, we have already discussed about the carbon nanotubes. Two main, that is a single walled carbon nanotubes, multi-walled carbon nanotubes, or the titanium dioxide particle, nanoparticle. If they have fibrous homogeneous shape, it also disrupt the internalization as well as the membrane disruption. And their main influence is on the phagocytosis mechanism, because it blocks the transport channel of the many chemical. It actually blocks the transportation of other chemical through the blockage of transport channel. And what is the physiological response of this blockage? It can be understood by the chronic inflammation, that is due to the frustrated phagocytosis, it may occur. Other example is, let us suppose titanium dioxide, it also show the agglomerate homogeneous shape, and the aggregation or the agglomeration, it changes the size of particle and therefore increases their visibility to macrophages also. Now what are the physical response of this shape? The aggregation, it changes the retention time of the particle as well as the change in the size, which may increase or decrease the toxicity. Other, for example, metal oxide, which have the heterogeneous agglomerate shape, it also disrupt the cell membrane. And the physiological response, that is a very similar to the previous one, that is aggregate particle and the fibrous particle, they also result in the cell division dysfunctions and disrupted cellular trafficking also. So this is all about the morphology, how the morphology, it affect the toxicity or the nanotoxicity of the this nanoparticle. Now another is the charge, surface charge, that is the surface charge. Because positively charged nanoparticle, they are mainly uptake by the this cell, they mainly uptake, because cells have the negative charge, they mainly uptake the positive charge nanoparticle. Now as compared to the neutral and negative charge particle, positive charge nanoparticle, they are mainly uptake by the cell, because due to their electrostatic interaction with the cell membrane. Also, the positively charged nanoparticle, they are also capable of acting as a sometimes also called proton sponges, because that disrupt the lysosomes to enhance the cytoplasmic delivery and induce the cell death signaling cascades also. Now the surface charge, it also play a role in the toxicity because it influence the adsorption of ion as well as biomolecule that may change the organism or the cellular response toward the particle. And that is now mainly it is also believed that the cationic surface, they are more toxic as compared to the anionic surface, because cationic surface, they are most likely to induce the hemolysis and platelet aggregation, and whereas the neutral surface, they are considered to be the most biocompatible as compared to the cationic surface. So due to the high affinity of this cationic particle toward the negative phospholipid head group or the protein domain on the cell membrane, they mainly influence the protein binding, which in turn affect the organ distribution as well as the nanoparticle attraction toward the membrane. Now the next is the size. As we have already discussed, size, it also nanoparticle, they have very small size, therefore they have high surface to volume ratio, and therefore there is high reactivity toward the molecules. Due to their high reactivity, sometimes what happened that these nanoparticles, they also react with the non-targeted molecule also. That also result in the toxicology of this nanoparticle. Another is the solubility. Then the poor soluble nanoparticle, they are considered to be cause cancer, and also they show the toxicity in the body. Then is the chemical composition. Chemical that are mainly adsorbed on the surface, because the chemical of the nanoparticle, chemical composition of the nanoparticle, it also determine the shape and size of the particle. So this slide, they show why the nanoparticle are considered as a toxic, or what are the possible risk. Possible risk is toxicity. Why nanoparticle are toxic? Because of these property, because nanoparticle have this property: surface area, morphology, chemical composition, size, surface charge, as well as the solubility. Now the we have also, because possible risk are at the level of synthesis also, at the synthesis level, at the packaging level, at the handling level, and at the and the worker who are actually involved in the synthesis of this nanoparticle. So also in the previous module, we have already discussed about the different methods of synthesis of this titanium dioxide and carbon nanotubes and dendrimers. So there in the aqueous system, the carbon nanoparticle, they are subject to precipitation and aggregation because of their inherent hydrophobicity. This limit their use in the aqueous as well as the biomedical application also. Now that we have already studied that the researcher mainly performs the chemical modification to enhance the activity depending upon the function of this that nanoparticle, which are involved in the various function. For example, if we are carbon nanotubes, they are involved in the adsorption of heavy metals, then researcher perform the chemical modification. It also affect the fate and as well as the behavior of this nanoparticle in the environment. Now the carbon nanotubes and their derivatives, they are, because they are mainly, these nanoparticles are also used in plastic, catalyst, battery, fuel cell, electrode, supercapacitor, water purification system, orthopedic implants, conductive coating, adhesives, composites, sensors, components, and also in the electronic, aircraft, aerospace, and automotive industries. Therefore, the increased production, it result in the adverse environmental effect. That is, there is a data that is 1500 tons per year that are produced. These are the 1500 tons nanoparticles they are produced per year. That is according to the data I have collected from the Frontier Carbon Corporation as Tokyo, Japan, as well as the Fullerene International Corporation, USA. Now the titanium dioxide and zinc oxide, they are used in the solar cell also, paint, coating, sunscreens, cosmetics, bottle coatings, because of their ultraviolet blocking abilities. So ultimately this nanoparticle, they are used, their consumption is increased day by day. Therefore, however, the data is not available proper, or the exact data is not available, but also their fate is not still clear. It is a point of research also. Therefore, they create the possible risk in the environment. Now, what are the possible routes for, because now we will discuss about the toxicity of this nanoparticle. First of all, what are the possible route for entry of this nanoparticle? First one is skin, and the main nanoparticle which may enter through the skin or through the dermal, that is a silver nano as well as titanium dioxide. These nanoparticle, they can enter through the skin or the dermal. And the type of consumer where these are used, that is a sunscreen, skin care, paint, coating and sealants, and as well as air fresheners also. Second route is the lungs. That is because these nanoparticle, as we have already discussed, they are present as a ultra fine particle because of their small size. They also, and the nanoparticle which are involved or enter through the route, that is lungs, that are metal based nanoparticles. And the type of consumer product, that is a paint, coating, skin care, sunscreen, food additive and colorings. Third route is the gastrointestinal, that is a tract which involves the consumer product, is food supplement, health supplement, as well as the food packaging. So these are the three main routes of nanoparticle from where they enter into the body. Now, however, several different mechanisms are available to test the toxicity of nanoparticle in the body, but mainly the toxicity, it is involved due to the production of excess reactive oxygen species. And one mechanism of this nanoparticle induced oxidative stress, it occurs due to the dissolution of iron based nanoparticle, which catalyze reactive oxygen species generation and formation of this, that is the radicals, hydroxide radical as well as the OH radical from the hydrogen peroxide through the Fenton reaction also. So the high level, that is the high level of this reactive oxygen species, these are the indicative of oxidative stress, and they can damage cell by peroxidizing lipids, altering proteins, disrupting DNA, and interfering with the signaling function, and also modulating gene transcription, and finally ending up in the cancer or the renal disease or neurodegeneration disease or the cardiovascular or the pulmonary disease. And in the cited literature, there are a lot of examples where the researcher has studied the toxicity of this nanoparticle in the various organisms, where they have also determined the lethal dose or the concentration, how the concentration of this nanoparticle affect the toxicity of this nanoparticle toward the organisms. So there are many cited reviews are available online where they have extensively studied the toxicity of these nanoparticles, and it is a possible risk, it is a main risk, because as we have already discussed that their consumption of production are increasing day by day. However, the exact data is not available. Therefore, they posing the problem of health risk, that is the main problem of these nanoparticles. The risk assessment, as I have already mentioned, currently no data on the concentration of this nanoparticle in the environment is available. However, the International Council of Nanotechnology, they has created a database of all publication of several nanomaterial along with their impact on environmental health as well as the safety. Now, the utmost challenge is the estimation of this deleterious effect on of a variety of this engineered nanomaterial with their dissimilar physiological, physiochemical property. For example, that is a small size, specific surface area, structure, aspect ratio, morphology, solubility, chemical composition, reactivity, photochemistry, as well as the production of reactive species and the surface property. Now, because of their nano size, these nanoparticle, because we have discussed in the fate or in the previous slide that there is a possibility of this nanoparticle to enter through the root, maybe the dermal or through the inhalation also. So they can enter into the, this nanoparticle enter into the blood and affect almost all organ of system of the body like kidney, then liver. So these are some of the organ which are mainly affected because they can enter. In the previous slide, we have studied the various entry route of this nanoparticle also. And also the metal based nanoparticle like that is a silver nanoparticle. And we have already discussed their mechanism of action also. So this silver particle, they can also lead ultimately to the pathway that lead to the death or apoptosis of the cell. So this is the main toxicity of this nanoparticle involved. Again, we have already discussed the three main entry route, that is lungs, which can cause nanoparticle that can cause asthma, lung cancer and pulmonary disease. Second also, that is we have discussed, that is the skin or dermal route. And third one is because due to the, I have already mentioned that the toxicity is due to the high reactive oxygen species level, and they mainly affect the brain cells because of high fatty acid content. They mainly affect the brain as, and acting as a neurodegenerative. So these are the three main route and the result or the outcome or the health risk that are involved in the three routes. For example, in skin, gut, blood, that is a liver, spleen. These are the organ which may involve, that is the autonomous nervous system, which can cause health disorder and cardiovascular death also. This actually show the, that is the actual fate as well as the their risk of these nanoparticles. For example, use of nanoparticle in environmental application, they can undergo the aquatic environment, that is a preferable sink for their, this nanoparticle. Soil is another risk, that is a preferable sink for this nanoparticle, and air or the atmosphere is another one. From the soil, it can go to the aquatic environment through the rain or through the other through the leaching method. Then they interact with the, because human, they interact with the air, water and food also. These human, they can come in contact with this nanoparticle. And similarly, there is a upper phase which showing the where are the risks involved in the nanoparticle. First one is workers which are involved in the production of this nanoparticle in the lab during handling and processing. Then the large scale production, it also involves the transportation and storage and the product end up. These all are their interaction with the human also. Human can, they can be interact with these nanoparticles that are present in the environmental application, and also during their synthesis, transportation and production, they human, there is a possibility of risk of this nanoparticle toward the humans. So far we have studied in this chapter, because this nanoparticle, it is a recent technique and it involves mainly the various branches, the knowledge of various branches like physics, chemistry, biology also. So this nanoparticle, because it involved, it is a recent technique for almost every researcher, because it is a recent technique which is introduced. So also the in this chapter we have, there is a risk for all that people or for researcher who are working in this field also, even in the, because it involves the combination of various field, even the mathematics also, even the physics, even chemistry and other life sciences courses also, or the students or the researcher. So there is a possibility of exposure risk for that researcher also. And these nanoparticles, because the risk is at transportation level, at the synthesis level, we have already discussed in this chapter, and also what are the toxicity of these nanoparticles, because we have summarized the various route, that is entry of this nanoparticle, and also as I have already mentioned, we have not included the exact, that is the toxicity in detail, because already in the cited literature there is available, because these nanoparticles affect almost all organ system of the body. So this is a possible risk posed by the nanoparticle itself. Then the to mitigating this ill effect, the various agency like Environmental Protection Agency of USA, they have set the mission for their possible risk of exposure. And also in the India also, the various funding agency like DBT, DST, they provide funds to the researcher to combat with this problem of nanoparticle exposure also. So that's all about this chapter. Thank you very much.